Hi, and welcome in this feature of the week video. Today, we will talk about editing models. It is an important aspect of modeling and simulation workflow. So whether you change a model from Monolix libraries, or you add an individual or recovery block in the model in Simulx, or you write a new model from scratch, you need a tool that will make this task a little easier. So today, we will talk about the MLX Editor. Models that are used in Monolix and in Simulx are simple text files, and you can actually open them in any text editor. But the advantage of the MLX Editor is its integration with the MonolixSuite applications, and in particular with the mlxtran language. So let me show you how it works, starting from Monolix. I have here a project with a model from the Monolix library that I would like to modify. In the 2021 version of Monolix Suite, the Edit button here opens the edition mode directly in the interface, and now I can make all the changes here and apply them in a few seconds. MLX Editor also helps with writing models in the mlxtran language. As you can see here, it has the coloring of the syntax for different elements, such as for the input here or for different mlxtran macros. Also, it gives suggestions and autocompletes variables, mlxtran keywords and functions while you are typing. For example, when you start writing, you get the list of options, and when you click on the tab key, you apply a selected item. Now, if I write DDT underscore AUC equals, and here I want a concentration variable, I can select from the list of available variables. MLX Editor has also typical text editor options, which are located here on top. There is a zoom in and zoom out option. You can undo previous action or redo the previous one, find a string, or find and replace. For example, let's say that in this parent metabolite model, I want to change the name of the transfer rate, which is here, from KPM to K. So I click on find and replace. First, I need to give a string of the name that I want to replace. So I write KPM, I click on enter, and now I write a string that I want to replace the previous one. So here I will write just K and click on enter. Now you can select if you want to replace each occurrence in the text, so the first one, second one, and the third one, or you can click on all to replace all occurrences of the given string. When you finish editing your model, one of the most useful features of the MLX Editor is the syntax check. As the name suggests, it verifies that there are no errors in your model, and if there are some errors, it will give you hints how to correct them. For example, let's remove the parameter K from the input list. If I click on the check syntax, MLX Editor informs me that there is undefined variable in the line 22, and this line is highlighted. I have to add the parameter K to the input line, and if I click on check syntax now, there is no syntax error detected. This feature can save a lot of time, as you do not need to save and load a model to see if it is correct. In MLX Editor, there are also several saving options. You have save and apply, in which you save current model with the same name and then apply the changes automatically in Monolix. There is also a possibility to save the model under a different name and then apply, or you can just save a modified model under a different name, but do not apply it to the current Monolix project. For models from the library, the save and apply option works as save as and apply. It prevents from overwriting the models from the library. The same options to edit model are available in Simulx in the section model in the tab definition. You can also edit a model, and here the syntax check will also verify if there are no errors in the individual and in the covered block. mlxEditor is an application of the Monolix Suite, and it has its own interface that you can use outside of Monolix or Simulx to edit models, write new ones, or also organize different models. The starting interface is typical for MonolixSuite applications. You can start a new model, which has a predefined structure for the longitudinal block. You can also open a model from your directory, or you can load a model from the Monolix library. For example, I can select a tumor growth Simeoni model. As it is possible to edit models that are going to be used in Monolix, or as in this model here with individual and covered block that are going to be used in Simulx, here in the left top corner, you select the version of the check syntax that are going to be used for your current model. And in addition, you can save and export the model from here directly to Simulx. To organize large projects with many model files that need editing or that you already edited, you can use the concept of sessions, which is available here in the top panel. Saving a session creates an mlxEditor type file with a list of all models that are saved and currently open in the editor, so listed here. Let's make an example. I'm going to close all the models here and open several models that I have in my directory. So model PK1, PK2, and PK3. Now I would like to create a session with these three models. So I go to the top panel session, save session as, and write, for example, my feature of the week PK models. Now I can close mlxEditor, and if I want to reopen all of these models that are in the sessions that I saved, I can just select the file that is here with the mlxEditor type and all models will be opened automatically. Also, do not forget about the possibility to use a dark mode in the preferences, or to increase the font size if the default one is too small for you. mlxEditor has been designed to work with mlxtran language and to interoperate with all MonolixSuite applications. And the goal is to make the model editing simpler and faster. So thank you for listening and take a look at other features of the week about mlxtran and model writing.